What's happening, people? Back with another reaction,
back with some more Smashing Pumpkins, and I'm very excited to announce two things. One, I received my copy of Disarm, which I had ordered when I did that first Smashing Pumpkins reaction. Took a little while to arrive, but it is now here. I'm very excited. This was the first Smashing Pumpkins I encountered. I had this album when I was in my early teens. I'm trying to remember exactly when it came out. This is a 2011 reissue. I would guess no later than 94, if not earlier, like maybe 93 or something. We'll have to see. I'll check in a moment. But yeah, I remember this album, and in particular, I remember the tune we're going to start with, which is not the first tune on the album. I do this sometimes when I get an album. If there's a tune that absolutely does stand out and that I remember like head and shoulders above the rest, I'll tend to start with that one and then go back and start going through the album proper. So that's what we're going to do here. And the song we're going to listen to is Disarm. I think this was a pretty big hit for them. I certainly remember the video. But yeah, I always enjoyed this for a number of reasons. One, the emotion of the tune just comes through like very profoundly. I mentioned it when I did a reaction, I think it was the first one I did, which was 1979. But I was saying that like when I heard this song as a young teen, it's not that it made me think about my own life or, you know, made me reflect to my time when I was a young boy and sort of growing up. It was more that like I could tell that this person was singing about something like immensely personal and emotional. Now, granted, you know, I didn't know the full story, and you know, people can sing lyrics that were written by someone else and are about someone else's life, but you know, because of the way they're a professional and a good musician and a good singer, it can feel as if they have lived that experience. So again, I don't know exactly whether this is, you know, Billy Corgan wrote this about his own experiences, or if it's, you know, sort of written through the eyes of someone else, or written by someone else and just sung by Billy. I'm not sure. I do think he writes a lot of their lyrics, correct me if I'm wrong, but at least, like, you know, back in the period when I knew the band, I do believe he wrote a lot of their lyrics. So yeah, this song always struck me as being immensely emotional, and I could just feel in the way he sings it, this depth, this emotional and psychological depth. So yeah, I, you know, as I sit here now, I know there is in some sense a recollection of earlier times in the narrator's life, and you know, sort of recalling the time when they were a boy, but I don't remember exactly, you know, how that relates to their emotional growth or to the other people, you know, their family or other people in their life when they were a little boy. Nor do I necessarily remember like the way in which the name of the tune, Disarm, which, you know, you can be disarmed emotionally and sort of be vulnerable because you've let someone in, like past your defenses, because you lowered your arms, if you will. It could also be a literal like removal of a weapon from someone's possession. But yeah, I tend to think it was likely more metaphorical and or emotional. But yeah, since it's a song that I only remember, or not only, but I more remember the sonics and just sort of the chorus rather than the wider thematic elements. If you do have an angle on this one, do shout it out. And big ups to the people who've already sort of commented on the Smashing Pumpkins reactions. I've only done a couple at this point, but this is just the beginning. And indeed, not only do I have Siamese Dream, but look what I did. I replaced my copy of Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness, and oh look, there's the first disc. So now that this entire album will be gone through, and I'm debating if I should go do the Dawn to Dusk disc first and then jump back to the second disc. I've only done two tracks from the second disc, which is from Twilight to Starlight. So I'm thinking that's probably what I'm going to do. I'm probably going to go back to Dawn to Dusk, go through that one, and then I'll go through the rest of Twilight to Starlight. So yeah, let me know what you think about that. But ultimately, let's get to this one, which is Disarm from their album Siamese Dream, which I apologize, I should have looked this up before, but just give me one moment. So Siamese Dream originally is from 1993. So yeah, right around the time when I thought it was. I was born in 1980, though my birthday is at the end of the year, so I was probably like 12 when this came out, about to turn 13. So yeah, it made a big impact on me at the time, and it's the reason I bought Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness right when it came out. So here we go, Smashing Pumpkins, 1993, and the song is Disarm.
The bells.
gravity of the piece. Masterpiece. I mean, there's still lyrical elements I'm trying to sort of piece together and kind of understand, exactly all the sort of elements at play. But the emotion in that song, even without knowing all the contours, is just overwhelming. The sonics really convey the gravity and the depth of feeling excellently. And once again, any tune that has string writing like that, just forget about it. That's a masterpiece, and I'm remembering now why I loved it so much. I mean, I already kind of, recalled it as one of my favorites from them, but wow, that was an experience. As I said, after this, I'm going to jump back and I'm going to go through the rest of the album in order. So we're going to go back to the very first tune, which is, what does that say, Cherub Rock? I think it says Cherub Rock. So I'm interested by that. In fact, there's a few interesting titles on here, including Mayonnaise and Space Boy and Silver... Is it Silver Fuck? Wow. I didn't remember some of the titles on here, so I'm interested to go through them. I'm really excited to start, revisiting and expanding my experience with this band, because I think I've been sleeping on them too long, even though they were sort of an influential group at a critical juncture in my musical life. It's clearly time to start... intensifying and fleshing out my understanding and knowledge of Smashing Pumpkins. Let me know if you're here for it. As I said, the next one from this album will be Cherub Rock. Other than that, thank you for listening and watching. I will see you next time.